All right, we're recording?
Yep.
All right, so the outcome that we want is we're gonna work on the Leaderbits database structure. So the current stuff in the applications, we got users and accounts. The users and accounts are already over here. A user has an account, right?
Right.
The account has many users. But the thing we have to do now is like the lessons we're gonna call leader. Oh, so the outcome is that we MVP the data structure models. Right? So that's all I wanna do in this session. I wanna be pretty quick. Because I was just going to generate the models and I'm like, how's it laid out? Okay, so the concepts we have in the application is we have a leader bit, right? Table form, this is a leader bit. And this is the like actual application, the actual like video.
Mm-hmm.
The video lesson that people will be doing. Okay. So here we'll have a title or a name. We'll have the URL to embed the video, and then we'll have title, and then we'll have a description, and that'll be text. This will be a string. This will be string two. Okay, mm-hmm. So we got the leader bit itself. Then we have the users and accounts. I'll just make this. Of course, has the ID. I leave out the ID, the updated at, and the created at fields because Rails automatically does them, and they're in my head, they're there, so I'm not putting them out there in this session.
Okay.
That's the lesson, essentially. Then we need an entry for the Reflect database. We'll have an entry, and an entry belongs to a user. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And an entry has, I don't know, body or content. We'll name it a body or content. This will be text area. Text is stores more data than a string. There's integers, text, strings.
Mm-hmm.
So people watching this don't know, Jake's new at programming, so I'm just iterating over everything. So you got user, the body, which is a text. Obviously this is an integer because it's an user ID, right?
Yep.
You get the body, all the timestamps are already there, and that's good enough for now, right? Okay. Then we have this concept in the application of only like one leader bit being active at a time, right? So we'll need a way to know what user is interacting with what leader bit inside of what state. So I'm imagining right now that's like an index you pick from all the leader bits. You go into one, you start one. Once you choose to start one and actually do it, then you have to see it through completion and you won't get another one
mm-hmm.
until the next time. So we'll need to know the time that they started it and the status and like what dictates it being complete.
Right.
Right. Here we're also going to need to associate it to the leader.
Right, yeah, that makes sense.
Right?
Yeah.
Because you need to know
which entry goes
to watch leader bit.
Yep.
Right? Okay, because the wireframes are on the other whiteboard, so those would be good to have, but it's okay. It's a very, very simple application. So the next one we'll need to do is a table to, or a model, obviously, to pull together the leader bit and the user and the status. And ultimately we're going to do it to the status. So we call like leader bit. We'll call leader bit status until I come up with a better name.
Mm-hmm.
Because we're just doing this off the top of our heads, right?
Yeah.
Good luck whiteboarding data models in front of video for the first time. This is quite interesting. I haven't ever done this on video. Alright, I've done it with teams where like I get people to, but this is new by myself, a video. So we'll do a leaderboard status one, right? I'm sure there's a better naming structure for that table.
Right.
If it were like in Rails and it was just a standard join table and we didn't need more information other than joining them, then there's a way to do that with element of PQRST. Yeah, so it would be like leader bid statuses or whatever it is. There's some naming schema for a join table, but we're going to have more information on it than just the join. So it's going to need to be its own data model that we can interact with.
Right.
So what we'll have here, this will connect the leader bid.
Leader bid and your user ID.
It'll connect the user ID.
And then you'll have maybe a status.
It'll connect the status. And
maybe a date. You're putting date?
Yeah, so we're definitely gonna need a date for something.
Mm-hmm. Like date accessed or, you know, I don't know.
Yeah, we need the start time.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, we will need a start time. Oh, call started at. And then. Yeah, we'll keep this started at, and then just for the sake of it, I'm gonna say
maybe an expiration or something, just to have something there for now.
Say this again?
Expiration.
Well, yeah. What would the expiration do?
Well, if you're having only one open up at a time,
yeah,
you know, so that you can't just go click through them all,
mm-hmm.
you know, you have it started at, and then maybe say it expires a week after the start date or something like that, whatever. You know, we decide on whatever arbitrary number. But yeah, you're completed at, you know, it's kind of the same thing.
No, you bring up a good point that I want to think about real quick.
Mm-hmm.
So I go in and I click start leaderbit.
Mm-hmm.
And then in my head, I imagine, all right, I'm going to tell people it's one every 24 hours max, but programmatically, I'm going to let it slide at 8
mm-hmm.
because it's like a work day.
Yeah.
The thing I want to prevent is people going through there and clicking through all of them and starting all of them and then like burning out, because if they get the information too quick, it's just going to be like, they're not going to use it.
Exactly.
So we need to like drip it to them in a sense. So if we said like one every 24 hours to them and then we just programmatically blocked it off every 8 hours.
Right.
So here's what's needed to change the status. Here's the thing. So when I go make an entry in there, that's going to have some effect on the status. So
mm-hmm.
like, it's gonna be, you're gonna need two requirements to change. I'll just put this over here. So what changes the status? To complete.
Right.
And it's gonna be two things. It's gonna be 8 hours, right? Plus entry. So you're gonna need 8 hours plus an entry. Because
yeah.
if 8 hours goes and you haven't entered and
it
didn't
won't roll
it.
Over, yeah.
So that's what equals completed.
That makes sense.
Completed status. To get to the started status, you go index, you read. Summary, click start.
There
right?
you go. Yep.
And then those will be the two things we focus on right now. They're either going to have like started and completed and your status. I don't know how clear I want to make this in the database, but I'll probably just put three states. I know it's gonna be updating data and stuff, because we could make a method on the model to say status, and the status logic will just be whatever. But also when I'm exploring data, I kind of want that ease of use to see the status,
mm-hmm.
like immediately in the database.
Right.
So I'm gonna go ahead and take that. I'm gonna allow myself to just update the status column just for the ease of use when browsing and debugging.
Yeah.
And then I'll always use in the application the status as what to rely on, because these things might change and improve, but the status will always be the status.
It's always either.
It's also
yeah.
the name of the table. So now that we know that, we'll know that. Okay, obviously. Status can be a string, probably an integer though, because there's like these things called enums that I can use in Ruby, which is like, really, it's a plugin called simple enum that I like, which relates like status back to an integer, very simply defining the model. So I got started at, completed at, the updated, created, all this stuff is already there. I want the completed at for, I want to know the space between these two.
Right.
That can live in the model because I don't need to see that in the database. The space between these two so that we can use that in our algorithm for momentum and stuff like that. This has the leader bit. There's already the timestamp on it, so that's why I can detect the rate at which they're entering and making entries into the leader bit, right? I'm just thinking out loud now. And so now we have all of this information, and what other features do we need, like that are required? You go in, you take the leader bit, you do, it starts, right? It starts, boom, 8 hours starts ticking, right?
Right.
We'll have to put that logic in the model to check, like set the time, right? So that'll be a task that probably runs. Maybe come up with a better way to do it while I'm doing it. Then we have an entry. So you take a little bit, you watch the lesson, you make the entry. Great, great, great. You can edit your entry all you want. You can then, that's it. You get the experience, you make the entry, and you're kind of like done.
That's our MVP so far.
That's our MVP, right? There's nothing more. Oh shit, oh, oops. Just kidding, kids. We had, for our MVP, we wanted to do the points thing. So I'm gonna do the most basic points thing in the world, or just like pop-up point thing, so that you get points towards the entry. So what we'll do is we'll do a points table, okay? Points model. And the points will be associated with like the user, obviously.
Obviously, yeah, user.
User, obviously. And do you know why we don't put the account anywhere? Like, I haven't put the account anywhere.
No.
The reason why is because you can always get to the account through the user. So you don't need to put it here.
Right.
All you have to do is
relate it back
to the user.
Yeah.
And the user already connected to account.
Yeah, relate.
If we put the user and the account on everything, it would just be like
redundant. Yeah.
Redundant, yeah.
Now you relate users to accounts, and
yeah,
then that's all you gotta do.
Yeah, you go up the chain. So we need the user. I'm gonna have some internal description of the points. Like internal. Like the reason why I'm giving them the points. I'm gonna do a polymorphism. Well, I don't know. Let's see. Yeah. Yeah, I'll do polymorphism. Why not? So polymorphism is when, if I want to give points to a leader bit or an entry, right? I got a couple ways to do that. I can either just like continually like put, oh, you know, internal description why they got it. But sometimes you'll want to get back to it. So like if I'm looking at the points and I want to click back to that leader bit, I need a leader bit ID to make that, to build that link. Because I'm only looking at the points section right now, right? It's isolated. So how will I know what leader bit they got these points on? I need to reference it back. But if I put leader bit ID and then I put entry ID, then I need logic to determine which one's blank to know which resource they actually made a point on. Did they make a point on a leader bit ID or did they make a point on a entry ID?
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? So then I would have like leader LB ID, right? And then I would have entry ID, right, and then I'd have number of points. And I would always be having a function in the model saying, is this, does this have an ID or is it nil? Right? Like, does it have something or is it nil? So that way I know, right? So if leader bits has an ID, if it's present, then show the leader bits resource and like link to that.
Yeah.
Or if entry ID, but then like if you start adding points to more things, then you're gonna get this nasty logic. Well, so there's this thing we can do, and I've written a polymorphic model in about a year or so, because I already have all my stuff abstracted, so when I need polymorphic comments and stuff, I already have. But the term, I think, I mean, you just call it like a, forget it, I'll call it an object ID.
That's what I was figuring, is like you're creating.
Like an object type.
Mm-hmm.
Type. Okay, so what this would be a type of leader bit,
mm-hmm.
or entry, and this would be the ID of that, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you can have object ID 1, which is the first, and then object type is leader bit, so that'd be the first leader bit.
Mm-hmm.
Or an object ID of 1, and the object ID of type as an entry, so that'd be entry 1. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So now, all you have to do is do object.id, and then that's the ID for the thing, and then you do object.type, and you can actually convert this type into the model. So like in the code, rather than doing like, you could do point.object and get the URL for it.
Right.
Right, because Rails has these helpers in there built in. So you can, and you know, all the different frameworks are gonna have different versions of this too. Polymorphism is a concept that transcends
all object-oriented programming. Yeah.
Yeah, so what you would do is, there's all these helpers for it, so that you can just go right to where you need to be.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll do the type, object type, and somebody's getting furious at the screen right now, because object, I don't think is the word, but that Rails uses, but or that we'll use to describe this, but you get it.
It's the concepts, people.
Yeah, it's the concepts. Higher level thinking. Actually, this would be a good point out, good time to point for leader bits. If you're so concerned about the semantics of that, that's an issue in itself. You've already lost. And that's why you need to register for leader bits right now, because you gotta let go a little bit from that.
Mm-hmm.
Like, good luck. There's how many languages on earth, and English is like how popular?
Right.
Right? There's other languages. People speak more like languages, different languages. So you have to just, the word for object in a different language is not object.
No.
It's like, hung da. You know, just say that up. Watch that be like a curse word. All right, so we got points. So what's gonna happen is we're gonna do some sort of, like when they go make an entry, it's gonna go boop, boop, and they're gonna get some points for it. And the points are gonna be determined on a special algorithm, which we're not releasing on this video yet. And so they're gonna vary, it's not gonna be the same points every time, it's gonna be points based on how good the entries are.
Mm-hmm.
And it's gonna be leader bits based on how good they are. It's not a speed test, it's not how fast can you work through it, it's how much experience can you gain, and that's the algorithm we're gonna have.
There you go.
For being able to do that. So we're going to do some points, we're going to have a status, we're going to have an entry, and we're going to have a leader bit, and the points are going to be polymorphic to associate to a leader bit or an entry, so you're going to get points for both. We have this concept of 8 hours. We've got the started status, right? And then the other thing we'll need is a... So this completes our data models.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so we'll say, all right, we're done with data models. And then now we're gonna work on forms. Okay, so based on these data models, we'll need some form, we'll need a registration form. Which will include an account, and user details. So, all right, so now they got a registration form, done. Now they're an account,
mm-hmm.
right? Now they go to a leader bit. All right, so first they register, right? So step one, register. Step two, they're going to, so this will be the forms for the CTO flow as a company account?
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I'm gonna make this even more simple. Alright, so okay. When they get to this form, they register, and now it's going to be invite.
Yes.
They need an invite, and here they're going to have a form to invite team, which is going to need a name, an email. OK?
Mm-hmm.
And then this will send invitations out to
No.
Which we have, that whole invitation process is already handled by this other thing we have. So we
have, and they'll have to register on there as well.
Yeah, they'll have to like complete. Mm-hmm. So they'll go back into the registration form process. So then the register, you got the user and the account. You got the thing. Now, do we send a welcome email?
Probably not. Maybe right now. I mean, you can if you want. But you can also have a welcome page that they go to after registration is complete.
Yeah. Well, I think the, like, yeah, welcome page will be like, you go to welcome page, you can invite. See, they're going to probably, as humans, they're probably going to want to do two things. They're either going to want to, like, explore or invite their team.
Right.
Right. So we'll, like, allow them to explore or invite team. Alright, they can invite team. They invite team, they go that, and it sends invitations to the team.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Then the next form would be, or I guess they'd go here now, to actually do a leader bet. Right?
Right.
There's a leader bet. Leader bet index, and they'll look, pick. Again, right, look, pick, reflect.
Mm-hmm.
Alright.
Then maybe the next, you could do like a progress after that.
Reflect, get points. This is points. Points. Yeah. Okay, so you got four. They're gonna reflect. Oh, on this form, this is a form. Reflect form. Looks like this. You have, what do we call this? Text, like body. Submit. Then we have edit.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so we'll have an edit function, submit function, reflection function. There you go. That's really simple. You'll have an index and a show. All right, so you have an index and show. On the show index, you look. We'll do I, you look. Index, you pick. Show, we'll call it show. By the way, I've never done this I and S thing before, I'm just doing it. Show you reflect and show you watch, right?
Yeah.
I kind of merge these into four steps, right? So you look, you pick on the index, then you reflect, you watch and reflect on the thing. The watching is clicking the video, the reflection is just typing the body. Great. So then, and then what will happen is, I think we should send an email after complete. Congrats.
Congrats.
Completing your first beta bet.
What if you send one to the CTO, like this team member has completed a leader bet?
Yeah, I think what we'll do is, like, for Monday.
Right, yeah, because we're coming out. That can be later.
So what I'll do is I'll say, like, some of these things aren't going to be done by Monday because it's Friday. And I have to film videos with me. But we're trying to get all this done, right? And it's going to be accessible on mobile, and I need a mobile first with Foundation. So what I'll do is I'll come in here and I'll cut the email scope to the last.
Right.
So like those are things I can do Monday or Tuesday or Wednesday, right?
Yeah.
But I definitely want to do things like completed emails, right? I want to do completed emails. I want to do obviously the invitation emails would be somewhat of a requirement to get your team involved.
Mm-hmm.
For MVPs. That would definitely be it. Completed emails and then sort of like reporting. So I guess what you do is you take it, right? And then you're gonna report on it.
Right.
And so the report goes two ways. Oops. This is fine. So report. There's two aspects. There's the individual. Right? And then
mm-hmm.
there's the company. Okay. And so the individual report would be what are the metrics for the individual report, Jake?
The individual report, you're gonna want to know how many points you gained.
Okay.
Per liter bid.
Uh-huh.
You're going to want a report of your reflection and
so we'll do the table.
Mm-hmm.
That's our points table essentially.
Right.
Because our points table is actually the log of what we've done.
Mm-hmm.
That's interesting, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so the points table actually contains the leader bit. Right?
Right.
The entry. Leader bit one, entry two, whatever. Or maybe we should do it leader bits first. I wanna do the origin on the leader bit.
Okay.
So I'll go leader bit. And what will happen is you'll have bit one, and then you'll have, so that's like the title.
Mm-hmm.
So the title, points, entries, show. Like you'll go to a link.
Right.
You know? So that way you can see, all right, I did this leader bit, I got this many points. The points is a collection of total points.
Mm-hmm.
That's entries plus duration plus like all these, whatever algorithm we do. And then this will be like a button, right? So you can go to it. This will be like three entries, right? And this will be like 72 points, right? And this will be the title.
There you
all
go.
Right, but up here in the graph to look cool, what graph should we have? Like I want a graph to look cool.
Mm-hmm.
Should we do it points by day? That's easy.
Yeah, it's an easy way to start.
Like points by time?
Yeah.
That's simple. So it'd be a little graph like this, right? And here we go, points. And here we go, time.
There you go, that's easy enough.
So it'll look like this.
Now.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of cool.
Yeah.
I kind of like that. All right, cool. Company. What we'll do is the idea here is to see your people as a whole
mm-hmm.
and what they're doing. So for the company one, what's the most simple graph? You want to stick with points by time? Or what do you want to do?
I mean,
so
you could
the
do different recordings.
The personal one, you want to see points by time because
mm-hmm.
that's kind of like the momentum.
Like, if that's something they can click into maybe somebody individually, but maybe you want to see how many people are doing how many entries per day.
Yeah.
You know, or something like that.
You know what else I want to see as an individual, which I completely forgot? This whole concept is like the carrot. Like, what am I working towards?
Mm-hmm.
And how far am I there?
Right.
So that's what we really need there. We need to ask, like, what are they working towards? And how close are they? So, because that's the whole point of the system,
mm-hmm.
right? And I'll have to think about that, because you have points. Points are kind of like your progress to the carrot, right?
Right.
But then it's like
we got to put the carrot there.
We need the math for the carrot,
mm-hmm.
right? So we need to see the like working towards the carrot. So we'll have to figure that out. I'm not even sure what to do with that. But for the company, you want to see, so that makes this really simple.
Mm-hmm.
So what you'll see is, you'll see the person, and you'll see Joel, and and you'll see the progress. Right?
Right.
We'll probably put like a momentum or something, like 92 momentum. And then we'll put like progress. And then we'll put like person.
There you go.
Right. And then that way we can
click into each one individually, maybe.
Yeah. And then we'll probably have a recent reflect, like recent entries here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because you want to be able to read their entries and stuff too.
Right. And then we'll have like everyone who's recent. Joel, the bit,
mm-hmm.
the entry beginning. So they can read it, like, we want them to be like, not have to click a bunch. We want them to be like, expand that or something, right? And then eventually we'll add interaction and stuff. But the person, they want to see how close, like, they want to see their momentum too, if we have this momentum thing, right?
Right.
See, that's more than enough. If we've got these three things, get the your points over time, your momentum score, and like working towards your carrot,
mm-hmm.
that's really simple. And those are just a few queries. The company, you've got, you can see the person in the progress towards the carrot or, you know, activity, right? You can see recent entries, and you click into the person, and there, right now it probably won't be like a whole lot of clicking into the person, but we'll probably make that page eventually.
Right.
The point is to have something to show.
This is a good
that
start.
Can be done by Monday.
This is a good start. We got our data models.
Yeah, got our data models.
We, got our
we just have to figure out the carrot real quick.
Yeah.
And so the carrot will be determined based on the company is going to want to define the carrot. So why don't we?
I mean, we don't necessarily have to have carrot in MVP.
Yeah.
We can take that as feedback of what would your carrot be? Ask it as a question.
That's the better thing to do.
You know?
Yeah. Momentum's cool because that's easy. So we'll put carrot as like...
You know, ask it as feedback.
Yeah,
because you know?
The thing is, the carrot's going to be tough because it's not going to be tough to define for the company. It's going to be tough because every different company is going to have a different way to define it.
Exactly.
So, you know, why don't we do the MVP of carrot, right?
Mm-hmm.
And we'll just put the... instead of it being a progress bar, it'll be text.
Right.
Carrot. Which is essentially the why. And it'll be just some description. That way, the reason why they're doing this is always in front of them.
Mm-hmm. Definitely.
Why not? Right?
Yeah.
And for now, it doesn't even have to be it would be kind of cool, though, if it were by the person. Like, their name. Like, if I was addressing my company. If I was like, team, this is why.
Mm-hmm.
Right, you know? So, for right now, we'll just make the carrot, like, a why. And how about I put it on the accounts tab?
Right.
Right? Right, that's the carrot. So now you always know what you're working towards. And so that way they can just say it here. You know, keep adding points for X amount of time and, you know, watch your stuff grow up, like grow, and we'll figure all that out.
Yep.
But to not creep our own features, which we just totally did. and then, of course, the emails here, we want to be able to use the system as much as possible without actually logging in.
Right.
So the email here would be the individual progress report.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And then same here. So we'll have progress reports for the teams. These aren't being the MVP. And then this is an email. I'm gonna start marking emails green. Alright, so this is an email, this is an email, this is an email, this is an email. That's a page. Two is the page. Welcome page.
Mm-hmm.
Because we definitely need to explain to people what it is. Or at least give them the option to skip it. So they come in, they register, they get the welcome page where they see a video of how to use it,
mm-hmm.
right? Video how to use it. And then they can choose whether they want to jump right in and start playing with it, or they can invite their team. And then they go right into leader bits, right? and they can run a leader bit themselves, do a reflection. Eventually, we want to complete it. Congrats, your first one. We want a whole series of emails that motivates people to keep going. Then they're going to have a report, a progress report, right? Then progress report for the company and report page has an individual view and a company view. And we'll probably just when you click on the company, they just get to go right to the individual's own individual analytics view. So we can reuse that view. And then the care is just going to be some static text about why. Because that's so important, though.
It is.
It sounds simple because it's simple from a feature point, but it's not simple from a human point. From a human point, you need to keep that in front of you.
Yeah.
All the time. You need to know why you're doing it.
You got
to
remind yourself of why.
Right. And actually, I'm going to creep this a little bit.
Oh, yeah. This whole video is creeped. It was supposed to be a short one. We're at 35 minutes.
Yeah. Well, we have this outcome. We achieved the outcome. We just kept going.
We did. It's great. Yeah. No, it's awesome.
Well, at least we got something done. It's worse when you have a meeting and it's 35 minutes and you don't walk away with nothing done. Plus, I'm fixing to sit down and do this.
Yeah, exactly.
And I didn't have a roadmap for it.
Yeah, you've drawn the whole roadmap.
Hold on a second. I almost forgot. What did I just say I was doing?
You were going up there to do emails.
No, I was going to creep it a bit because I want the user to define their own carrot, Jake. I want to throw that back in their face. In a loving way so that they do better. It's like the... You get an overweight person and you're a personal trainer and you make them write down why they're making this change in their life, because when they're in the state that they're going to make the change and they're going to do better, they'll list out the reasons why, then life's going to creep up on them. And they need to see it in their own words why they're doing this.
And then you remind them in their own
words. I'm going to do leadership because I want a better life for my wife and daughter. I want a better life for my family. I want to grow as an individual and I want to make progress. These are the reasons why I'm entering into LeaderBits.
That makes sense.
So that when I can send them an email saying, hey, this is why.
Smart.
It reminds them. It's psychology of making the app effective.
Yeah.
So I want the users to also define their own carrot. Their own why. I got Simon Sinek's book over there on my desk, eating in the back of my brain. And then that's going to be an email eventually.
There you go.
For retention. Low activity. Motivation.
There you go.
Right, and we'll even put that on their dashboard. Why for the company and person. Here's the reason why I got the system for you. And here's the reason why
you're doing it for yourself.
Mm-hmm. That is so important.
Yeah, it is.
Right? We should probably include that, we should probably make that available not just on the report page, but up in the navigation or something like that. We should make that more in front of them. And we should include that. We don't want to overuse it, so if we overuse it, it becomes familiar. So we probably will use it for drop-off, if they've noticed they haven't done a LeaderBit in 2 weeks or something like that. Again, and now we can tell when they haven't touched a LeaderBit in 2 weeks based on this information.
Right.
There are plenty of emails that come out of here. There's plenty of crap to just completely make this undoable. But one of our LeaderBits is keeping it really small and simple, right?
Yeah.
Because it's easier to get started. And by going in, and I'll remember this. I'm removing it. I'm trying to make it more simple looking, right? No more colors. We have registration, this, invite, LeaderBit, report, and, two reports. Your why, that's a text field. Your 8-hour thing, your point system. There wouldn't be a form for this. This is going to be a pop-up though. And then you get your forms. And then your last one, let's make it up. You got your auto actions. The auto. Things in the models that we'll need for to trigger. We'll call them trigger. Right. We'll need the triggers for the
inactivity.
Status changes.
Yep. Status change, inactivity. For your emails.
I'm not gonna put inactivity yet, because that's creeping my MVP too much. We really need an email for the status change, click, a trigger for, I'll consider the email triggers, all email stuff. And then we'll need Our status change, that's what it is. Oh, and then the points.
Points like momentum. You have points towards momentum.
When the points happen, this needs to be some sort of like JS animation.
Mm-hmm.
Ajax. I'll just like Ajax some graphic or something. Just
right.
Like,
yeah. Easy enough.
On create only. Maybe. For now. My mind's already creeping this as I'm writing it.
Stop creeping.
As you edit it and improve it, maybe. Now, screw that. All right, so we really have a very few things. We need all the emails set up, which is great because I already have it running through Postmark.
Mm-hmm.
We need the thing to run the status change because of the hours, right?
Yep.
We have our interactions, and this is the entire MVP, the data models, the everything, and this looks good, right?
Yeah.
It's really only 5 screens. And my admin interface is just going to be my command line interface for now. If you're watching this and you have some great stuff, like I know there's active admin, and like, but if there's anything new that's really great, let me know. And then now I have to go to the bathroom.
Alrighty.
There we go. There's our update. There's an entire application. Are we still recording?
Yeah.
Oh, there's an entire application completely mapped out that will be built this weekend.
Awesome. Bam.
Yeah.